Police are investigating after a body was found inside a submerged pickup truck off I-10 in New Orleans East. The truck was pulled from the water near the Michoud exit on Wednesday. Police say they're investigating this as a fatal crash, but don't know how long the car was in the water. The victim's name hasn't been released. Federal reform officials overseeing the NOPD are expected to release the department's first report card. The court-appointed monitors were called in to evaluate the department after a federal report described the department as poorly trained and corrupt. The Golden State killer has been cleared in the 1975 murder of a 14-year-old girl. California investigators say DNA evidence in the case of Donna Richmond shows Joseph D'Angelo was not her killer. This morning's business report, the Justice Department has opened a criminal investigation into automaker Tesla over statements made by CEO Elon Musk. Last month, Musk tweeted he was thinking about taking the company private and had secured funding for the deal. It's being called one of the largest undercover drug busts in NOPD history. Police say they've arrested more than 70 suspected drug dealers in a large-scale operation that started back in May. All the dealers were caught selling various drugs to undercover officers, ranging from crack cocaine to heroin. Police say they still have more than 50 people that they plan to arrest.
We heard your complaints. We heard your concerns. We heard it from non-PAC meetings. We heard it from community meetings. We heard your complaints through anonymous tips, and we did something about it.
Superintendent Michael Harrison says the focus is on drug dealers because most of the violent crimes in New Orleans are connected in some way to narcotics.
Hey, good morning. That's right. It's about an hour delay. President Trump was supposed to be here at around 10:55. But according to officials here, the crew needed to reset an indicator light, which unfortunately delayed his arrival a little bit. So we're currently waiting for the president and Air Force One.
Well, it's no secret by now. Anthony Davis says he has no intention of signing a contract extension.
What is the NOLA mural project?
The NOLA mural project is a community organization, a community effort to get street art up in New Orleans. And we match artists with willing wall owners and show what can happen in a neighborhood when there's not a lot of bureaucracy and oversight, just artists and property owners that want to create public art.
But the street art could be in jeopardy. In November of 2017, Morris was threatened with fines and jail time by the city because he failed to apply for proper city permits. The ACLU sued the city on Morris's behalf, arguing that displaying murals is a constitutional right and that permitting regulations are an over-restrictive violation of First Amendment rights.
When you open up your Insta and see an artist that we've worked with has posted, and then artists that they know that they follow post, and then they contact us, and then more art goes up, and it's been pretty incredible.
Morris hopes the appearance and popularity of the paintings will help convince the municipal government to lower the mural permit fee from $500 to $50. And judging by their social media engagement, the popularity is there.